everyone. Today, let's see how Chinese government bonds are doing so far this year. Because if they started the year on the front foot, they have finally been caught up in the turmoil of the bond markets. At the end of last year, the accommodative tone of the central bank made the country's government debt still attractive compared to US and European government bonds. This momentum continued into January, allowing the Chinese sovereign index to post the best performance among 46 Bloomberg government bond indices. Then, as soon as the war in Ukraine broke out, the index performance slipped to the 29th place. With no doubt, investors reduced their exposures as net sales of Chinese government bonds reached $5.5 billion at the end of February. How can this be explained? Well, some investors felt that the yield differential over US treasuries had narrowed sufficiently. The Chinese 10-year bond currently offers a premium of about 0.9% over its US counterpart. The spread was at 1.5% at the beginning of December 2021. Others have considered the fact that Beijing will issue more debt this year in order to finance a 5.5% growth target. This figure is at the higher end of many economists' forecasts, but as a reminder, China has not set a GDP target below 6% since 1991. And all this is affected by doubts about how much more room China has to loosen its monetary policy. That said, the central bank has announced that it will transfer more than 1 trillion yuan, or $158 billion, in profits to the Ministry of Finance, a move that will help the government increase fiscal spending. So we have on the one hand fiscal stimulus and on the others doubts about the authorities' accommodative potential. The combination is worsening investor sentiment about the risk-reward profile of Chinese debt. So it's clearly weighing on the bond market as the 10-year sovereign yield is now at its highest level since December, 2.86% on March 9. It had fallen to 2.67 on January 24, a 20-month low. And some specialists do not rule out the possibility of it reaching 3% in the very short term. Although the sell-off is all over the place, Bloomberg reveals that foreign investors are the ones who have been selling massively. And according to rumors, some of the movement could come from Russia. Following international sanctions that severely restrict the Russian central bank to access to its $643 billion in foreign exchange reserves. Data from June last year puts the yuan share at 13% of these reserves. It is therefore very possible that the Bank of Russia has sold Chinese bonds to generate liquidity. As it's often the case in a market shock, the most liquid assets are the least difficult to sell when it comes to generating liquidity. This is why it's hard to hide at the moment, even in China. Thank you. Yeah.